Today I'm going to teach you how to use the zoom effect in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. As I mentioned, today we will design this stunning template. You can download it for free in the description. You need to watch this tutorial to learn how to use it. But before we start, let me show you the pitch deck PowerPoint template that I have designed recently. This template has more than 140 unique slides, and each of them has its own features. By using this template, you will grab the attention of your audience instantly. This template offers professional designs that are fully customizable. Elevate your next presentation with this mind-blowing template. The link to download all the templates I have designed is in the description. Alright, let's dive in and start the tutorial. Let's start by adding the first picture to the slide. Put it to this position and then expand it from this corner until it covers the entire slide. Now add a new blank slide and insert the background picture. Since we don't want any accidental movement, right-click on it and lock it. I'm going to add some pictures, so let me add this tool to the Quick Access toolbar. Let's bring the picture frame to the slide. Right-click on it and choose Format Picture. In this window, add a drop shadow in this direction and set the distance to 7. Hold the Ctrl key down and make two copies of it. We need them later. Let me bring this picture to the slide. First, crop it with 16:9 aspect ratio and then set its height to 2.4. Select these two and align them to the middle and center. And then by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Okay, hold the Shift key down and rotate it 30 degrees. Or you can rotate it from this section. Anyway, let's bring the camera and the lens to the slide. Adjust their size and position, and then select both of them and add a drop shadow in this direction. Set the transparency to 10, blur to 75, and distance to 60. Now select these four pictures and bring them to the front. Let me rotate this shape 15 degrees and adjust it like this. Add two blank slides and add your content to each slide. I'm going to use these two pictures. Go to this slide and from the Insert tab, click on the Zoom and select Slide Zoom. I want to zoom on this slide, so select it and insert it. Change its height to 2.4 and then rotate it 15 degrees. Drag it to the inside of this frame. Select both and align them to the middle and center. Again, insert, zoom, slide zoom. This time choose this slide. Change its height to 2.4 and drag it to the inside of this picture. Why we are dragging it to the inside? Because if we align them in this position, the frame moves, but we don't want that. So drag it to the inside and then align it. Anyway, since I want to see the shadow of the camera and lens above the pictures, select them and bring them to the front. Let's add a slide zoom to this slide as well. We want to zoom into this slide. Change its height to 2.4 and rotate it 15 degrees. You can use the arrow keys for precise adjustment. Alright, let's see how it looks like. Very good, but I think the transition between these two is too fast. So select it, go to the Zoom tab, and increase the duration to 2 seconds. Perfect. Now I want to add the last slide. Select this slide and press Ctrl D to duplicate it, and then drag it to the bottom. Delete the extra parts and then adjust these two. Now draw a square and set its height and width to 5. Change its color and remove its outline. Open the Format Shape window and add a drop shadow in this direction to the shape. Increase the distance to 7. Now add a text box and type your title. Make sure it is aligned to the center. Change the font to Leek Spartan Black and its size to 88. You can download this font in the description. Go to the Shape Format tab, remove the text fill color, and choose this color for the outline. Now select the text box and the shape, and then align them to the middle and center. Press Ctrl G to group them, and then rotate it 15 degrees. To see the shadow properly, bring these two to the front. Select them and drag them to the center. For the last move, go to the Transition tab and add the Reveal Transition to the slide. In the Effect section, choose Through Black from right and you are done. Your PowerPoint is ready.